Hello and welcome back to the channel. As you all know, on-demand delivery platforms have now become as commonplace as any other household tool. People absolutely adore it. The ease of ordering anything and everything while sitting in the comfort and safety of our own home is a hard temptation to resist. Customers expect their on-demand delivery applications to provide them with immediate gratification, whether it is food, grocery, transportation, medicine, or retail items. So in this video, I'm going to show you the features and functions of a very smart admin panel for a pickup and delivery platform. Without further ado, let's get started with the video. What comes to mind when we hear the word dashboard? Of course, the all-in-one visibility of all the vital information that the admin requires. The admin can see the total number of users, drivers, bookings, and total revenue. So here is the section where the admin can also check the latest transactions, ongoing transactions. The admin can see the revenue generated by cash on delivery or online, the total number of users, and the total number of bookings on a weekly and monthly basis. Let's talk about manage users. So this is the section from where the admin can now review and manage the information of all its users by making changes to the existing information from here by editing or re-entering these details. The admin can also delete a user from here, from this section, and can see the blocked and unblocked users, the list of all these. If in case admin would like to search a user, the admin can do the same by just entering email, phone number, or customer ID. We have this export CSV option also. So this basically allows the admin to export the data in the form of an Excel sheet. In our platform, we are giving the admin complete control over the driver's information, including the ability to manage, add, and view it from this section. The admin can add the bank detail manually for a driver, his vehicle detail and documents, and also verify the same from this section. Now, let's talk about the logged in drivers, locked off drivers, and pending driver requests. So this is basically the section where the admin can review the logged in drivers, the locked off drivers with their status, block and unblock them, track them, edit the information, and further check the documents. From here, the admin can see all the pending requests and can take action against the same. If in case the admin would like to search a driver, the admin can do the same from here. The admin can also export the data in the form of an Excel sheet from this option. Let's move on to managing services. From here, the admin can add a service by just entering its name, its description, and can further save it by just clicking on this button. This is the area from where the admin can block and unblock a service by just enabling and disabling the status. The admin can delete and edit a service and can also has the ability to search for a service by just entering its name. The next category we have is manage cars. The admin can view the car category, dimensions, vehicle capacity, description, service, default labor, maximum labor, labor rate, loading, unloading time, extra time rate per half, wrapping description, wrapping price, each and every information, and whether it's coming soon or maybe coming in next few weeks from here, from this section. And the admin can also block and unblock the same. If in case admin would like to search any particular category, the admin can do the same by just writing the car category name here in this section. From here, the admin can take actions to the same and can delete and edit it further. This is the area where the admin can add a car category from manually by just entering all these details. That was all about managing car categories. Now coming to managing videos. This is the section from where the admin can add or upload a video to provide a better experience to his customers or drivers. He or she can further add a thumbnail to them, and if in case the admin would like to add more videos to it, the admin can do the same by just clicking on the add button. From here, the admin can manage the status, and whatever the status the admin will enable, whether it's on or off, it will going to reflect the same there in the application. This is the section to delete or edit the existing video if in case admin would like to. Now, let's talk about how to manage the zones that the administrator decides to assign to the driver for delivery. From this section, the admin can add a zone and then assign a driver to it. We have also given the ability to the admin to delete and edit the same from this section. You can also see each and every zone is listed here. One of the excellent features we offer is the ability for admin to view pending, upcoming, ongoing, completed, cancelled, and all bookings. He or she can also export all of the data from this page by just clicking on Export CSV button. And if the admin would like to see the list of all cancelled, completed, ongoing, upcoming, or pending orders, then this is the section for them. Let's discuss the managed discounts. So this is basically the area where the admin can view the category, code, name, type, value, start and end date, usage limit per coupon, usage limit per user/customer, use limit per coupon of an existing discount. And from here, the admin can enable and disable the status of the existing discount or promo code, and can further edit and delete it. By just clicking on the add button, the admin can choose a discount category, generate a code, discount type, then add a discounted value, the name, start and end date of this discount or promo code, and then add the usage limit per user/customer or the usage limit per coupon. And further, while after entering or each and every detail, can click on the save button and further save it. This is the section from where the admin can export the entire data in the form of an Excel sheet if the admin would like to. And from here, the admin can bifurcate the discounts as per the promo codes and user. The next functionality which we will be discussing is managed delivery pricing. So this is basically the section where the admin can define the delivery charge on the basis of zones. The admin can further edit and delete the existing category from this section. And if in case he or she would like to see the category, the list of a category of some specific category, the admin can choose the same from here, and accordingly the list will going to be reflected here. Same goes for service, zone, from which zone
the order has been picked up to the zone the order will going to be delivered. And this is basically the section where the admin can search for any of the category by just entering the name of the category, service, weight, dimensions, zone, etc. This is the section from where the admin can choose a category, then add a service name or choose it, add the weight, dimensions, the zone from which the order has been picked up to the area where the order will be delivered, and according to the same, the admin can add the price. By just clicking on the save button, each and every information will get added, and accordingly the delivery prices will be reflected there in the application. Now we have the most important functionality that is needed in any admin panel, which is manage revenue. In this section, the admin can see the total number of transactions which has been done digitally or via cash on delivery, and he or she can also check the earnings of the driver with all the information, that is driver ID, driver name, total bookings, total amount, paid amount, the amount which is yet to be paid, and can take actions to the same. From here, the admin can check the transactions and can also export the entire data in the form of an Excel sheet. To check the orders, whether it's done by cash on via cash or digitally, we have given the option to bifurcate and to check the list of the orders which has been done digitally or via cash on delivery. You can check each and every order from here, and you can also search for the same with the order ID, username, driver name, and can export the entire data in the form of an Excel sheet by just clicking on the export CSV button. Let's talk about sub-admin and the section to manage the same. We all know how difficult it is to run the application while working, and we all need the option to add the sub-admin to the platform who can manage at least some of the work. However, we don't feel comfortable allowing them to use the entire platform. To help you guys, we decided to find a solution for you. By clicking on Add Sub-Admin, you can define a role. You can write the name. You can add the email, phone number, street number, city, state, country, zip code, and can save it. Once the sub-admin has been added, from the configuration section, you can choose a role, and as per the role, you can grant the permission. By clicking on the submit button, the permissions will be granted to the sub-admin. From here, you can also block and unblock the existing sub-admins or different roles, and you can also delete and edit the same. This section will help you a lot to manage your work as well as the admin panel. Now, this is the area from where the admin can add a vehicle, the brand, the model year, the color of the vehicle, the capacity, and can save it further by just clicking on the save button. From here, the admin can edit and delete the same, and then can also search if in case the admin would like to search for any particular vehicle type or vehicle brand or the vehicle model. Into the manage walkthrough section, you can manage the walkthrough. From here, the admin can change the graphics for the customer app as per the screens. The title, the description, each and everything will be changed from here, and accordingly it will be reflected there in the customer as well as the driver application. Coming to notifications. This is the section where the admin has the ability to send the notification. He or she can choose the notification type, select a user, driver, notification mode, add the title, and write the message. With this button, the admin can send the notifications. Now, this is the section where the admin can review the notifications and can also search for the same.
Manage reviews. We have defined this section for managing reviews which the driver or customer will post. This is the section where the admin has the ability to search the reviews with driver ID, driver info, and many more.
Now coming to analytics. Here, the admin can analyze the data, the total number of users, bookings, drivers, and revenue generated based on the given period of time and on the basis of weekly and monthly analysis. Next, we have the section to manage CMS. If you are looking for a feature where you can change the About Us, cookies policy, privacy policies, terms and conditions, and many more CMS pages, this is the best platform for you. You can add, delete, and change the same from here, and it will be reflected on the website with the updated changes.
From settings, the admin can add the service cost based on different parameters. The parameters are after pending, after accepted, after start pickup, after arrived at pickup, after start delivery, time limit, opening, as well as the closing time. The admin can also store all the information by just clicking on the save button, and the information will reflect there on the application as well as on the website.
Let's talk about banners. This is the section from where the admin can add a new banner by just writing the name, description, start date, end date, and can save it or store it from here. Now, the admin can also view the listed banners by its name, description, start date, end date, and its status. The admin can also take actions to the existing banner by just deleting and editing the existing one. This is the area from where the admin can search for a banner.
That was all about the pickup and delivery platform admin panel. And as you can see, it was extremely simple to use. So if you plan to launch your own pickup and delivery service platform, I recommend that you click on the link in the description and assist us in getting this panel ready for your business. You can also email us at sales@apptunix.com. or DM us on our social media accounts. Do not forget to like, comment, subscribe, and press the notification bell to stay up to date on new videos. Thank you.